Join us on a journey into the silent world of scorpions. Fascinating creatures that thrive in the most remote corners of our planet. The realm of these arachnids extends from mountains to plains, from deserts to the rocky crawlways of the tropics and subtropics. Today, we explore their amazing anatomy, which makes them the perfect hunters of the night. From the fine sensors of their pedipalps to their deadly stingers, every aspect of their body tells a story of adaptation and survival in a world full of challenges. Scorpions belong to the class Arachnida and are part of the phylum Arthropoda. There are an estimated 1,750 to 2,500 species of scorpions worldwide, of which only about 25 are considered potentially lethal to humans. This impressive diversity is also reflected in their size, from the tiny Typhlocactus micellae, which barely reaches 9 millimeters, to the imposing emperor scorpion, which can be up to 21 centimeters long. These primitive land arthropods are known for their remarkable evolutionary resilience and adaptability to extreme conditions. The body of the scorpion consists of two main parts, the anterior prosoma, or cephalothorax, and the posterior opisthosoma, or abdomen. The prosoma is made up of five fused segments with six pairs of appendages, including chelicerae, pedipalps, and four pairs of walking legs. The eyes are also located here, with one pair of simple median eyes and two to five pairs of lateral eyes on the sides. The opisthosoma consists of two parts, the wider mesosoma or pre-abdomen with seven segments and the narrower tubular metasoma or post-abdomen with five segments. The mesosoma harbors two special structures, the genital operculum and the pectines, a pair of comb-like organs. The metasoma ends in a venomous sting consisting of the telson and the aculeus. The telson harbors the paired venom glands. The aculeus, a sharp stinger hardened by heavy metals such as zinc and iron, allows the scorpion to inject its venom into prey or attackers efficiently. This venom consists of a complex mixture of neurotoxic peptides and serves both to paralyze prey and to protect it from predators. Particularly remarkable is the ability of scorpions to adapt the composition of their venom depending on the threat or type of prey, and even to produce a pre-venom with different properties. Although scorpions can deter some potential attackers due to their venom, they are still vulnerable to predators such as owls, bats, snakes, lizards, and others who will take the sting for a savory meal. Certain scorpion species, particularly in the Butidae family, exhibit sexual cannibalism, where females consume males after mating. The digestive system of scorpions begins in the pleural cavity, a chamber-like structure at the front end of the cephalothorax. Here prey is grasped and crushed by the powerful chelicerae, supported by the pedipalps. The food is then transformed into a liquid broth, similar to spiders, by secreting enzymes to break down the prey and absorb the nutrients. The crushed food slurry then enters the mouth, which is a small transverse opening in the preoral cavity. From here, it leads to the pharynx, a muscular sucking piston that transports the food into the esophagus. The salivary glands, positioned on either side of the esophagus, produce saliva, which further breaks down the food. The midgut is the main player in this digestive process. It consists of a small stomach that merges into a long, narrow intestine. This intestine is divided into the anterior mesosomal and the posterior metasomal intestine. This is where the actual digestive work takes place. Finally, the undigested remains are collected in the hindgut and excreted through the anus. The hepatopancreas, also known as the scorpion's liver, is an impressive organ that occupies the dorsal part of the abdominal cavity. This glandular mass has a dual function. It produces digestive enzymes and digests, similar to the pancreas. Its secretion reaches the intestine via 5 to 6 pairs of hepatic ducts. It also stores nutrients such as glycogen and fats, regulates the water balance, and can even store metals such as copper and lead. It also influences the reproductive cycle of female scorpions by providing nutrients and water during pregnancy to support the embryo. The excretory system of scorpions comprises malpighian tubules and coxal glands. The malpighian tubules are fine tubes that are attached to the intestine and absorb nitrogenous waste products from the hemolymph and transport them into the intestine. The coxal glands near the base of the third leg also function as excretory organs. They consist of an end sac, a spiral tube, and a bladder that channels waste products out through a duct. The scorpion's respiratory system consists of lungs that enable them to utilize atmospheric oxygen efficiently. These lungs consist of 4 pairs and open through stigmata, narrow slits on the sternum of the 3rd to 6th pre-abdominal segments. The structure of the book lungs is fascinating. They are compressed sacs with an inner membrane folded into numerous fine leaflets. This increases the surface area for gas exchange enormously. Gas exchange takes place through the rhythmic expansion and contraction of the abdomen. The heart of the scorpion extends over several segments of its back. It has ostia, small openings, that regulate the blood flow. The scorpion's hemolymph, which serves as a blood substitute, is indigo-colored and transports the respiratory pigment hemocyanin. The nervous system of scorpions consists of a central nervous system, a peripheral nervous system, and a visceral nervous system. The central nervous system comprises the brain, subesophageal ganglia, and a double ventral ganglionic nerve cord. The brain is located directly under the middle eyes in the prosoma and controls complex behaviors such as hunting. The peripheral nervous system extends from the ganglia of the central nervous system and sends nerve impulses to the sensory organs and extremities to help scorpions explore their environment, hunt, and defend themselves from danger. The visceral nervous system autonomously controls important bodily functions such as heart rate, respiration, and digestion, which enables scorpions to react quickly in fight or flight situations. The sensory organs of scorpions include eyes, pectines, and sensory hairs, which are distributed over the body. Scorpions have a fascinating eye configuration, with 2 median eyes and up to 10 lateral eyes, supplemented by a light-sensitive sensor in the metasoma. The median eyes on the carapace provide clear vision and spatial resolution thanks to a visible lens and photoreceptor cells surrounded by light-sensitive rhabdomeres and pigment cells. The lateral eyes, without a vitreous body and connected by rhabdomeres, offer less optical acuity but act as highly sensitive light sensors. These specialized eyes enable scorpions to detect differences in brightness even in dim light. The pectines, comb-like limbs of the scorpions below the walking legs, are covered with tooth-like projections on which hundreds of pin-shaped sensitive sensory organs, the so-called pegs, are located. These structures are primarily responsible for chemical perception by picking up chemical signals, such as odors and pheromones, from the environment with the help of 100,000 sensory neurons. In addition, the pectines act as mechanosensors that detect physical changes in the substrate, such as surface structures or ground vibrations. This ability enables the scorpions to explore their environment and detect prey or mates. Scorpions have separate sexes. The male reproductive system consists of testicles, vas deferens, and other specialized structures. The female system comprises an ovary, oviducts, and a common genital chamber. Fertilization is internal, and most scorpions are viviparous, with embryos being nourished in the womb. In the secretive realm of scorpions, complex mating behavior takes place, including a ritualized dance, the promenade à deux. Male scorpions use visual, mechanical, and chemical signals to attract females. They recognize potential mates using pheromones, which are perceived by their pectines, and also differentiate between pregnant and non-pregnant females. The mating dance culminates in the transfer of the spermatophore from the male to the female. Some species even reproduce parthenogenetically. Scorpions are viviparous with different forms of prenatal development, apoikogenic and catoikogenic. After birth, the young spend their first stage of life on their mother's back, where they receive protection and care. Scorpions go through up to 9 molts in their lifetime in order to grow and reach sexual maturity. This process, during which they emerge from their old exoskeleton, is crucial for their development. The first molt takes place on the mother's back, and the young scorpions are particularly vulnerable. After the last molt, which marks sexual maturity, the molt cycle ends. Scorpions have the potential to live for 15 to 25 years or even longer due to their slow metabolic rate. In the nocturnal deserts, scorpions display a fascinating green-blue fluorescence under UV light that covers their entire cuticle and remains even after their death. Scientists have discovered that special chemical compounds in the cuticle are responsible for this glow. The exact function is still unclear, but it is thought that the fluorescence may play a role in UV detection. Our journey through the mysterious world of scorpions ends, but leaves us with a deep understanding of these amazing creatures. Their role as natural hunters helps to maintain the ecological balance. The scorpions teach us respect and admiration for the small but mighty heroes of our ecosystems and encourage us to appreciate the diversity and beauty of life on our planet. Thank you for joining us today to learn more about the fascinating world of scorpions. If you want to learn more about other fascinating animals, subscribe to my channel and activate the bell so you never miss new videos. Share this video with friends who are also interested in animals and science. And leave a like if you enjoyed this insight. Your feedback and support mean a lot to me. See you next time.